Good morning, Doctor. Dr. Thompson, just so the jury knows, you never treated Deborah Ann Kay, is that correct?
That is correct. I was engaged to render an opinion.
Engaged to render an opinion for a price. That is correct. You are being paid to be here.
Just as you are, sir.
Are you board certified in anesthesiology?
No, I'm not. It's quite common in New York State to practice.
Yes, I'm quite sure it is, but this is Massachusetts. Are you board certified in internal medicine?
No.
Neurology?
No.
Orthopedics?
I'm just an MD.
Do you know Dr. Robert Towler?
I know of him.
How is that?
Through his book.
What book is that?
Methodology and Practice.
In anesthesiology.
Methodology and Practice in Anesthesiology, yes.
How old are you, Doctor?
I'm 74 years old.
Do you still practice quite a lot of medicine?
I'm on the staff of anesthesiology.
Yes, yes, I've heard that. But you do testify quite a bit against other physicians, isn't that correct? You are available for that, so long as you're paid to be there.
Sir, yes. When a thing is wrong, as in this case, I am available. Mm-hmm. I'm 74 years old. I'm not board certified. I've been practicing medicine for 46 years, and I know when an injustice has been done.
Do you indeed? I bet you do. It's fine. Fine. Let's save the court time. We'll admit Dr. Thompson as an expert witness.
Mr. Galvin, you want to continue now? Oh, we could resume with Dr. Thompson this afternoon.
I'll continue, Your Honor. Dr. Thompson, did you examine Deborah Ann Kay at the Northern Chronic Care Facility last night?
I did.
Objection.
Sustained, yes. The witness will confine his testimony to review of the hospital records.
Dr. Thompson, in your review of the hospital records, May 12, 1976, in your opinion, what happened to Deborah Ann Kay?
Cardiac arrest. During delivery, her heart stopped. When the heart stops, the brain is deprived of oxygen. You get brain damage. That's why she's in the state she's in today.
Dr. Towler has testified that he restored the heartbeat in 3 to 4 minutes. Now, in your opinion, is that an accurate estimate?
In my opinion, it took much longer. 9, 10 minutes. There's too much brain damage.
Are you saying that a failure to restore the heartbeat within 9 minutes in itself constitutes bad medical practice?
Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Galvin.
If I may be permitted to question my own witness in my own way.
I'd just like to get to the point, Mr. Galvin.
I am getting
Mr.
to the...
Mr. Galvin, I believe I have the right to ask the witness a direct question. Now, let's not waste these people's time. Answer the question, Mr. Witness, please. Would a 9-minute lapse in restoring the heartbeat in and of itself be negligence?
In that small context, I would have to say no.
Then you're saying there's no negligence, based on my question.
Given the limits of your question, that's correct.
The doctors were not negligent. Thank you.
I'm not through questioning, Your Honor. With all due respect, if you're going to try my case for me, I wish you wouldn't lose it.
Thank you. I think that's enough for this morning.